I was just asked a couple of hours ago about the Poisson model and looking at the over-under gold market. So far I've always been talking about trying to predict what the match result is going to be. You know, whether the home team is going to win, whether it's a draw, or the away team. While here, I want to look at whether we get more than three goals. I was kind of making some kind of response or reply when I thought, actually, it makes more sense just to make a series of videos. Because actually, I haven't studied it. I haven't looked at how it does. The basic idea is we're going to use the Poisson model, we're going to get the data from soccerstat, and we're going to make predictions. We're going to make, say, two things about each match. So one, I'm going to look at whether it's accurate. So how often, you know, when the Poisson model says I expect the home team to win, or say when the Poisson model says that I expect three or more goals, is it typically right? Two, if I bet using the Poisson model, does it work? So if the Poisson model says something is going to happen with 70% probability, so I expect it to happen, but the betting markets say it's more like 50-50, then there's value there. So then if I was to trust my model, I would bet. So for each match, I'm going to try and make a forecast and then make a decision about whether to bet or not. We get the data from soccerstat. So I'm going to be looking at the Premier League. So I clicked on England. I want goals data, so I click on goals. I need the goals scored and conceded by the teams. So I clicked on scored conceded tab. And I'm going to use home and away because some teams have, you know, different behavior when they're playing home and away. So this gives me better resolution, I think. But again, the best way to check is to see how well it does. So, you know, to make predictions using the average over the entire season, make predictions using home and away, you know, and we want the one that does better. I'm going to use the same program, which I've used for predicting results. You can get that program since it's from my course, Speaking R, the Language of Data Science. So this program, the code for that is included in this course, so you can just download it. And it also tells you how you can get the program R and install it, which is free. So I mean the R program. It's also on sale at the moment, so very reasonable. So I'm going to look at three matches. Liverpool-Bournemouth, Southampton-Chelsea, and Burnley-Leicester. For each, I'm just going to get the data from soccerstat, and I'm just going to plug them into the program in R. In the Burnley-Leicester match, we can see that we expect less than three goals nearly 70% of the time. So the model expects there to be less than three goals. In the Southampton-Chelsea, it expects, well, it's very 50-50. It expects three or more goals 48% of the time, less than 351. Because remember, this model, we plug in the data from soccerstat. So this tells me that Southampton, on average, score one goal a game at home. but they concede 1.31. For the league as a whole, the average is the home team scores 1.54 and the away 1.18. As we'd expect, so that kind of shows us that typically the home team wins. And these are the stats for the away team. So Chelsea typically score 1.73 goals per game and concede 1.07. And what this model does is it kind of normalizes it. So say Chelsea typically score 1.73, that's against a team that would concede 1.18 at home, because the league average is 1.18. But in this case, Southampton concede 1.31. So Southampton have a worse than average defence. And that's why we expect Chelsea to score more than normal. So we can see here, the mean for the away team is 1.91. So the model expects Chelsea to score more than they normally do. That's just about, you know, that's the internal mechanics of this Poisson model. So, as I said, it's 50-50. And for the Liverpool match, it expects 3 or more goals. But 57% of the time. So, we always have to decide. I mean, is that sufficient? I mean, is that... is my rule going to be I bet on 3 or more goals if it's more than 50%? Or do I have a threshold? Do I go, I need it to be 60 or 70%? So, again, remember, I'm looking at two things for every match. One, what is the prediction? And two, do I bet? For Bournemouth, there's a clear result. It was nearly 70% that it's going to be less than 3 goals. For the Chelsea match, it's basically 50-50. And for the Liverpool match, it's more than 50. So it is, I would say that that's high enough that I'm going to expect there to be 3 or more goals. So I've got the 3 model predictions. Again, I might change as we go through week by week. So at this stage, I'm interpreting a 56-57% probability as being enough to tell me that there's going to be 3 or more goals. But maybe I should be needing 70% or 80%. I mean, I don't know. The second part of the check was to look at the odds, to go, is this a good bet? We can do that by just dividing 1 by the odds. So that's 1.63. And remember, if I just click on the probabilities or the odds, we can just invert the axis and be given the probabilities. So the betting market is saying or thinks that we'll have less than 3 goals 60% of the time, while my Poisson model is saying it's going to be 68. So there's a potential that these odds are a bit off according to the Poisson model. So I'm happy to bet that we're going to have under 3 goals. I've also done a counter bet, because what you can do on a betting exchange is lay the odds. So you can be the bookie. And so what I've done is I've laid the odds at 1.1 so that I can kind of reduce my bet. The idea being that if we're, say, nil all at half time, then the odds for there to be less than three goals will shoot down. So the odds will maybe go down to 1.1, 1.2. And if I sell the bet at a cheaper price, I make profit. That's just, you know, the particulars of how I'm implementing the bet. For Chelsea-Southampton, the odds are nearly 50-50. So it's slightly more likely to be under three goals. Chelsea-Southampton, three or more goals, were slightly under... Oh, no. This is saying it's more likely to be... Yeah, it's more likely to be less than three goals. And it's more likely to be under three goals, according to the betting market. I wouldn't bet on this because there doesn't seem to be any value. It seems to agree with what the model is saying. And finally, if I look at the Bournemouth-Liverpool, here the odds for over... So the model said that it expects there to be three or more goals, but it was like 58%, I think. So it's nearly 50-50. So the odds really... I'd want odds of closer to 1.7, 1.8 at least. 1.4, 1.47 are a bit high for me. So if anything, I would take the counter bet. I would bet that there's going to be less than three goals because this price is too high. So actually, I'll do that. I think you can. Okay, you can also kind of shop around with this. So yeah, see, I was able to match my bet at 3.15, even though if I just clicked, I would have gotten 3.1. The idea here is that I think that these odds are too high. And now what I'm going to do is take the counter bet. Okay, so there, I said, if anyone wants a bet it's less than three goals at evens, I'm willing to take that bet. And I clicked on keep. So as the game goes on, this bet will stay there. So maybe if at half time or after 20 minutes, if it's still in all, people will start thinking, oh, maybe Liverpool are tired after their Champions League. They're safe in their top four. Maybe this isn't going to be a goal fest. And so these odds will start going up and these odds will start going down. And hopefully I'll be able to find a match for this bet. And then I'm happy. Because then I can't lose. Then if it ends up being a low scoring game, I win. If it's a high scoring game, I don't lose. Which is the kind of bet I like. So I went on a bit in this one because, again, I just got the question from the viewer. And so, you know, it wasn't that clear what is exactly it is that I wanted to do here. So I would say, from the point of view of going through the 5 weeks of looking at the overs and unders, the idea is I make a prediction for each result. And I make a bet or I avoid it. So from the point of view of this series, I'm going to imagine that I bet 10 euro or I didn't bet. In reality, I didn't. But just to keep score. So I would bet that we're going to have under three goals for the Liverpool-Bournemouth. I would bet that we'll have under three goals for the Burnley-Leicester. And I I wouldn't bet on the Chelsea match because there was no value. So we'll see how that goes. And then we'll be able to see whether this model, like this implementation of the Poisson model, adds value. Whether it's actually the numbers it produces are accurate and provide a way to make money. Fingers crossed.